In this video, let's take a look at how Synology's data protection solution, ActiveProtect, can help companies safeguard against ransomware attacks. Ransomware attacks usually follow a set pattern that can be divided into 5 steps: observation, infiltration, lurking, disruption, and negotiation. The first step, observation. Nowadays, ransomware attacks have become a business model, which means that they are planned well in advance and targeted at specific organizations. Before attacking, it will conduct research to better understand the industry or the specific organization they are targeting. After gathering all the information they need, they lock in their target. The second step, infiltration. Tactics such as phishing emails or ads are used to entice victims to click on links. The virus is then deployed and spread secretly within services used by the company. Most corporations might not even realize that they have been infected by ransomware. The third step, lurking. When hackers are lurking around, they are gathering valuable information, such as R&D secrets or critical services, about the company they aim to target. When they believe the timing is right, they will attack. During a ransomware attack, files are encrypted for ransom, and a company's ability to recover its data is compromised. This also includes deleting all information related to your backups, so that only an encrypted copy of your data is left behind. Lastly, the hackers demand a ransom while holding the organization's data hostage. Hackers usually threaten to publicly disclose or delete company information if the ransom is not paid when going through a ransomware attack. Do businesses really stand a chance? Hackers can try attacking multiple times as long as they succeed once. Businesses only have one chance to protect themselves against ransomware attacks, and they need to dedicate time and resources to do so. To prevent ransomware infiltration, businesses can implement encryption, firewall encryption, or raise the security awareness of their employees. They can also run behavior analysis scans or virus scans regularly to check if ransomware is hiding within their systems. Based on past experience, no organization can protect against cyber attacks 100% of the time, while no cybersecurity vendor claims their setup can eliminate ransomware entirely. Which is why organizations have to learn to prioritize recovery. This is why backups are regarded as one of the most effective defense against ransomware. Having a recent, secure, and verified copy of your backups increases your likelihood of restoring data successfully. This also reduces the risk of data loss and minimizes downtime. These are the 4 key elements of ransomware defense: safeguard data, guaranteed backups, confident restoration, and access control. First, let's start with safeguard data. ActiveProtect Appliance will be capable of protecting everything within an enterprise, from endpoint devices to core infrastructure and data centers, such as virtual machines, file servers, databases, and even extending to cloud services. While addressing the mentioned challenges comprehensively, it also incorporates built-in off-site backup capabilities to meet the 3-2-1 backup principle. The off-site backup destination supports ActiveProtect Appliance, highly scalable Synology Nest models, as well as cloud storage, Synology C2, and AWS S3. New virtual machines and SaaS accounts are added to your organization and environment on a regular basis as the IT landscape evolves. Synology ActiveProtect is capable of proactively protecting all workloads as well as any newly added workloads. With auto protection capabilities, ActiveProtect ensures that data from new workloads can be secured against ransomware, eliminating potential security vulnerabilities that may arise as data grows. Second, let's move on to guaranteed backups. First of all, ensuring the integrity of your data is a must. As traditional storage systems cannot report errors, users are not informed in time, which results in corrupt data, which could continue to affect future backups. With Synology's years of experience in the data storage field, we have now incorporated storage technology into our data protection solutions. Detect data corruption via BTRFS, and perform self-healing capabilities via RAID storage. Ensure data integrity via ActiveProtect's hardware and software integration as the first step to ensure backup restore capabilities. When combined with Synology's built-in hypervisor, the built-in virtual machine will automatically turn on the device that has been backed up. The entire process will be recorded for documentation purposes, and IT personnel can then verify the availability of their backups via the video, marking this as the next checkpoint for data recoverability. Next, enterprises can run periodic disaster recovery drills via Synology's built-in virtual machines to test their backups and meet audit requirements. Companies can actually recover their data to Synology's built-in hypervisor in real time to ensure their data can be recovered anytime without affecting their production site. Based on this premise, data can be restored flexibly. ActiveProtect comes with built-in immutable capabilities as we've integrated worm and object lock features to automatically lock both local and off-site backups. The duration of the data lock aligns with the data retention policy you've set within your protection plan. By contrast, other vendors tend to set a fixed immutable lock duration for the entire storage destination. Not only does ActiveProtect reduce human errors, but it also actively optimizes storage space. Next is about air gap mechanism. Before we get started with air gapped backups, let's take a look at how air gaps work. Air gaps have to be set up within the network environment of your company for maximum protection. You have to connect the management port and the data port to two different network segments. The management port should be connected to a secure enclosed network at the company as it is for the management console, while the data port should be connected to the company's production network as it is mainly used to transmit backup and recovery data. This is to ensure that employee workstations, internal systems, as well as SaaS services can be backed up and restored with no difficulties. ActiveProtect Manager's air gap mechanism allows users to turn the data port on and off via ActiveProtect appliance. Users can also set backup windows and choose what time they want to transfer data without impacting the management port. If you are looking to further isolate your data, you can turn off the backup appliance. There are three types of air gap. The isolation effect becomes more powerful as we move from left to right. Denying all connections. This blocks all incoming data via a built-in firewall, but it does not impact outgoing data. Disabling network cards and turning the appliance off. This blocks all incoming or outgoing data. In terms of backup copies, ActiveProtect will queue the tasks and will keep on retrying until the air gap period has ended. All backup versions will then be backed up in order to meet compliance requirements. Lastly, denying all connections differ from disabling network cards and turning the appliance off, as you are still able to perform disaster recovery drills with backup copies. Users can select a method that best suits their needs. Third, let's talk about confident restoration. ActiveProtect lets you restore previous versions of files via file-level restoration. This allows employees to download files or folders via a self-recovery portal as long as they have permission to do so. The option of bare metal restoration is also available with ActiveProtect. When disaster strikes, companies are able to fully restore systems and applications and their work environment. This is crucial for workloads such as physical and virtual machines, which directly impact enterprise development and services. ActiveProtect also supports cross-hypervisor restoration. If a service interruption occurs, companies can instantly restore data stored on physical or virtual machines via VMware or Hyper-V. The service will be restored within minutes, minimizing downtime and allowing companies to meet their target recovery time. Let's show you how it works. First, navigate to the Protection Plan section through the left panel. Here, you can define protection rules for the workloads you want to protect. These rules can later be applied to multiple or cross-platform workloads, automatically protecting them based on the defined rules. Enter the Protection Plan page and click Create Plan in the upper right corner. For this demonstration, we will use a protection plan for physical devices and virtual machines as an example. First, you can choose the plan type and decide whether to apply immutable rules. Then, click Next to enter the name for the protection plan. After entering the name, you can configure the backup settings, including retention periods, backup schedules, and more. Next, configure the advanced settings for the respective platform, such as enabling backup verification to make sure data integrity automatically. Finally, the protection plan integrates with backup copy settings, allowing users to enable this feature directly and choose a destination for off-site backups. Click Next to complete the setup. After setting up the protection plan, if the target to be backed up is a virtual machine, switch to the Virtual Machine tab in the left panel. Using the auto backup feature, the system can automatically detect both existing and newly added virtual machines in your environment. First, click on Auto Backup Settings and then click Add. Select the backup server and the target VM folder. Then apply the protection plan. Once the setup is complete, any virtual machine, whether already existing or newly added to the selected folder, will automatically be protected according to the applied protection plan. This ensures there are no data silos. To verify the backup immutability, let's take the virtual machine PM demo as an example. We can see that this VM has already been applied with an immutable protection plan and has been copied to an off-site destination. If we attempt to delete the corresponding workload, you'll notice that the user is unable to delete the files from APM. Next, let's switch to the off-site Active Protect Vault, where the backup data are stored. Select the corresponding file and attempt to delete it. From the screen, you'll see a notification indicating that the data is undeletable. This demonstrates that data backed up on the Active Protect appliance with an immutable plan, whether it's a backup or a backup copy, will maintain an immutable state throughout the entire data flow. In the event of an unexpected incident, we can help the user instantly restore their data to minimize server downtime. Select the virtual machine you want to restore. Then click Restore to Virtual Machine in the upper right corner. You can choose the latest version or a specific version based on the desired point in time. After selecting, click Next to choose the target platform and the restore mode. Since we are assuming this is a recovery drill, we can choose to restore to a new location to avoid affecting the original setup. Once selected, proceed to choose the restore destination, which can be a hypervisor from the existing infrastructure or a new hypervisor. Click Next, then select the folder and resource pool. Finally, click Done to start the restore process. The user can monitor the details of the restore progress and, once completed, can migrate the instantly restored VM back to the production environment. This ensures full disaster recovery and guarantees business continuity. Lastly, let's talk about access control. First, let's start with firewall settings. Just like general devices, Active Protect also comes with firewall settings. By default, we use a whitelist to only allow ports that are required to be accessed by Active Protect Manager. In addition, if users want to further restrict device access, they can create a whitelist of IP addresses that are allowed to access each Active Protect appliance. Active Protect comes with several login methods for managing personnel. Not only does Active Protect support the most common username password login method, but we've also integrated Active Directory and LDAP and support SSO and MFA to improve login security. We also support 2FA for super admin accounts to ensure they are thoroughly secured. Delegate granular permissions via Active Protect Manager for users who have already logged in. When designing Active Protect, the idea was to implement the least privilege, making the permissions more granular and flexible to meet the different delegation requirements of teams across a company. For example, if you are a company's chief information officer, you will have access to all the permissions to better manage teams. Enterprise companies use granular permissions. For IT teams that only have to manage infrastructure, we also support downgrading admin rights so that the admin account can only access system management privileges. Admins can also delegate specific permissions, such as backups and recovery permissions, to teams responsible for backups and recovery. Lastly, Active Protect Manager also supports delegating permissions such as viewing status or self-service recovery permissions to third-party auditors or regular employees. Identity authentication services have to be integrated to prevent unauthorized access and achieve 100% data security. Active Protect Manager works to proactively detect any hardware issues, send out notifications in real time, and automatically repair corrupt data, which is why Synology has incorporated these to ensure the accuracy and security of your backed up data. In summary, Active Protect Appliance not only simplifies IT backup management architecture, but also provides a comprehensive data protection strategy. It ensures the security of data and allows on-demand retrieval in case of unexpected events. Additionally, Synology adheres to its commitment to product security, with a dedicated cybersecurity team conducting final checks to minimize security risks. It is an ideal solution that meets the best practices for enterprises in establishing ransomware recovery plans. Secure your data, scale your business with the Active Protect Appliance.